Once a year, under the light of the full moon, something spectacular happens beneath the waves. This is coral spawning. It might look like snowflakes floating in the water, but they are actually packets of eggs and sperm of the corals. Triggered by water temperature and the lunar cycle, corals release their eggs and sperm all at once. Once fertilized, they develop into tiny coral larvae called a planula. The planula swims through the sea, searching for a place to settle down. Corals might look like colorful plants or rocks, but they are actually animals. The planula attaches itself to a hard surface like a rock or old coral, and it transforms into a tiny animal called polyp. The polyp clones itself, creating more and more polyps. These polyps stay connected, and together they form what we call a coral. Each polyp has a sac-like body with a mouth at the top, surrounded by tentacles. Inside its soft body, the polyp has tiny algae called zooxanthellae living in its tissues. These algae use sunlight to produce food for the polyp through photosynthesis. In return, the coral provides them with a safe place to live. The algae also give corals their bright colors. Each polyp has a soft body, but it builds a hard skeleton underneath itself. This skeleton is made of calcium carbonate, the same material found in seashells. As more coral polyps grow, their skeletons stack up, forming a large structure, a coral reef. Over time, as thousands or even millions of polyps live and grow together, they build huge coral reefs. The Great Barrier Reef in Australia is the largest coral reef in the world that can be seen from space. As the coral reef grows around an island, it creates a calm, shallow area of water around the island. The water inside the reef is usually clear and light blue, while the deeper ocean outside the reef appears darker. This contrast makes the island look like it's surrounded by a circle of water. Coral reefs also act as a natural barrier between the ocean and the land. When big waves or storms come, the coral reef breaks the waves and slows down their energy, making the water much calmer before it reaches the shore. However, when corals become stressed by pollution or increased water temperature, they expel their algae. This causes the corals to lose their color, revealing the white skeletons of the corals. This is called coral bleaching. Without the algae, the corals lose their food source, making them weaker. If the stress continues for a long time, the corals can die, and this harms the entire reef ecosystem. Coral reefs are one of the most diverse ecosystems on Earth. Despite covering only about 1% of the ocean floor, they are home to around 25% of all marine species. Coral reefs provide shelter, food, and breeding grounds for countless species, making them vital to ocean biodiversity. Protecting corals is essential for maintaining biodiversity in the oceans and our planet.